If you want today, we still stick with inequality. All right. Last video I put, and I showed you the core quadratic inequality, and I showed you the solution for sorting out that. All right. So today I got another example about 5x/5 take away by 5x/3. Bích cả mùa giãn dữ dội. Alright, the question asks you find out volume of x. Make that happy, alright. So today we still use the solution you sketching. Right, sketching. Sketching graph a function. Sketching. Sketching graph of the function. Y equal 5x/5. Take away 5x/3. Or what? When you got graph of this function and we'll show you the value of x, make that happy, the inequality happy. All right. So before you start sketching graph of the function, you have to find value of x when this function across of x axis first. All right. The function y equal 5x/5. Take away by 5x/3. Cross the x axis. As when the function y equals 0. All right. So easy. Just let 5x/5. Take away by 5x/3 equals 0, and you got put 5x/3 outside and inside bracket, you got 5x/2 take away by 1 equals 0. So you got x equals 0 and x equal positive and negative 1, isn't it? Alright, so of course now you got 3 points, yeah, when the function cross axis when x equal 0, of course the function will be equal 0, x equal 1 and y equal 0, x equal negative 1 and y equal 0. All right, and next step, you have to find out the turning point. The turning point, that's meaning when the graph have the gradient change, yeah, from increasing and decreasing. All right, so that you just do. Find the correlate of the turning point. Okay. You just do differentiation of function y, you could five x per q dy dx equal 25x/4 take away 15x/2, isn't it? Do you know at the turning point, at turning point, turning. Yeah, at turning point. The differentiation of function will be equal to 0, dy over dz, 0, isn't it? Yeah. So just let 25, 15 IQ equal to 0. And you find out the value of x and you got the correlate of turning point, isn't it? So you got you put it out 5 x square outside and inside what 5 x square take away by phi equal to 0. All right, that one equal to 0. So you got x equal to 0 or x equal positive or negative square root phi over 5, isn't it? All right. So actually, you don't need phi. You don't need calculate the value of function at turning point. You don't need it. Because you how you find out that because you determine at turning point that maximum or minimum. All right, that's it. Yeah. Now you determine. You have to determine. Yeah. The ratio, of turning point, points, alright. About for you, that's meaning you just determine the turning point. This is the maximum or minimum, isn't it? Alright. Before you do it, you just do differentiation the function again one more time. Differentiation d square y d square x, yeah, equal that 100 x cube take away 30 x or what, all right, square. If you want to determine that natural of turning point, you just substitute a value of x at turning point inside that one. Now, substitute value x of turning point inside this bracket. Alright, so if x equals 0, so you substitute here that you got this and this square x equals 0. At here, the point, the gradient not changed, that you can say that stationary point. Alright. If x equal positive square root phi over phi, you substitute on that one. You got put it out phi over phi, a square root phi over phi outside inside what 100 times phi over phi and take away by 30. Yeah, that one bigger more than 0, isn't it? So when that one bigger more than 0, so this point is minimum. Yeah, that's it, minimum. All right, now you substitute x equal square root negative square root 3 over 5. So you got d square y and d square x equal put negative 3 over 5 outside, inside what 100 times 3 over 5 and take away by 30. That's smaller, more than this all. So this point is maximum. Maximum. Alright, maximum. You got maximum. Yeah. Okay, right. So you got the coordinate of the coordinate, the value of x when the function cross of x axis, and you find out the correlate of turning point, and you load the turning point that maximum or minimum. Now you got all of information for sketching of graph of this function, right? Third choice. Yeah, I put more there for you to see it, right? Now you just show that the function, the graph, sketching that on the diagram. Here always y and here always x. Alright, here 0. So look, at x equals 0, so y equals 0. Here, yeah. And x 1, 1, and negative 1. Because the function, the graph of function cross of x-axis at 1 and negative 1, alright? And you look negative here, negative 3 over 5 around here, negative square root 3 over 5, and here positive 3 over 5, alright? So this point, the graph will be got the maximum, yeah. So that will be like that, and here, and at positive square root 3 over 5, the function got the minimum. All right, so the function of y equal 5x, 5 take y 5x cube. All right. Now look at the look at the graph. You can let you know the value of x make the function the bigger more than zero, isn't it? So you look at graph. Look at graph. You see x from negative 1 to 0. Okay, x from negative 1 to 0. Yeah, the function got the value of bigger more than 0, so yeah, and from 0 to 1, the value of function smaller more than 0, so bigger more than 1 here, bigger more than 1, and the function bigger more than 0, so x bigger more than 1, yeah, so you want to now here, x from negative 1 to 0, yeah, and x bigger more than 1, yeah, that make the function 5x cube, 5x cube bigger more than 0, isn't it? So that meaning that the value of x you have to find. Do you understand, yeah?